Gentlemen, set your video recorders because this is the last interview that I will ever do for T4 because after this I'm going to retire. Ladies and gentlemen, Richard Ashcroft.
Thank you very much.
We're not worthy. Finally, Richard, I get to meet you.
Yeah.
I'm a massive fan of everything that you've done musically. I think
thank
the way
you
that
much,
you have
mate.
Rocked on for the past decade or so has been absolutely brilliant.
Thank you very much, man. I appreciate your support.
No problem. But let's go slap back up to there. You've been away for 3 years.
Yeah, it flies without you knowing it, doesn't it?
Unbelievable. Can't believe it. Does it feel weird to be back into the limelight?
Not really. I mean, it's, you know, when people say you're away for 3 years, it's like creative people, I think, it never goes away, whatever you're doing. You can, you know, every day there'll be an idea, there'll be a song, there'll be a chord, or, you know, for a few of the months you may be in a studio. So I kept on being creative. Me and my wife had another child, so that kept us busy, and 3 years just seemed to go by.
You're quite an intense songwriter because it has been documented that you kind of lock yourself away and kind of focus on writing and stuff. Do you take influences from family and your surroundings? Is it quite easy to put lyrics together?
Sometimes the easiest lyrics, like a lot of writers will say, will be the ones that flow as a whole vomit, a whole spew of the song will arrive in one moment, you know, and you're really lucky if that happens. When it happens, you know, it's something to be celebrated. Other times, I think there's certain tunes that I'll write that are based on loops, like taking back to Bittersweet Symphony, that could take 5 or 6 months before the final lyric comes together. It's like a working process constantly, like a painting that you keep going back to.
When you're performing live, I mean, everyone talks about your performance at Live Aid.
Right, yeah.
Everyone's saying, oh, Richard Ashcroft, you know, he's back. And I was like, he never went away. He's always on my CD player.
That's the first thing you should say. I was talking to my wife about that this morning. So, you know, I read something already, someone saying, oh, he's back. He's back at his best, or back on form.
Yeah.
And it's almost like every time you start a new record, you either have to be back on form or...
Yeah.
No, it's the return to form.
Yeah.
And like you said, you know, you never do go away, but that's the culture we live in at the moment. Everything does have to have a label. Everything just has to be put in a nice little chicken nugget that they think we all understand. At the moment, mine's I'm returning to form, you know
the
what
return
I mean?
Of Ashcroft.
Yeah.
That's what it'll be on the front of all the magazines.
Yeah, return, yeah.
And what was it like being up there with Coldplay? Because obviously, since your band split up and you've done your solo stuff, other bands have kind of taken the limelight now. Was it good to be on stage with those guys?
We discussed it before and we rehearsed it once at Crystal Palace, and I think just from that first rehearsal I realised this was going to be something that we could easily pull off, because I think the band themselves, like, I'd say, you know, they're big fans of what I've done with The Verve and what have you, and we did Life's an Ocean together, actually, a track and all, so... That's it, man. You've got it. Yeah.
Great bass line.
And we did that in the south of France on the end of a European tour. So they even had that just off the top of their heads, and Chris Martin's got all the chorus spit on the guitar, and I'm like, Christ, I don't even know that. And he knows it.
Yeah.
So because they got the train spot a bit and the ability as well, though, that thing combined made it really easy, where it could have been, oh, this is weird, or this looks strange, or this is natural. Sort of felt quite natural, really, because they'd been through the school of Verve Rock or whatever at some point.
Verve Rock, that should be a good T-shirt, Verve Rock. On a different tangent, who cuts your hair?
My wife cuts my hair, yeah.
Will you do mine? You've always got a good haircut.
She's, she doesn't like doing it just before I'm about to do something, because there is a pressure there, but, yeah, I suffer from a bit of a bedhead problem at the back, but it's funny, in the years that I don't do anything or anyone sees me, I do go right back. I take it right back, yeah, and
Do you wear a side parting for official functions?
A side parting for official functions? I mean, if it's a travel lodge sort of rotary meeting, I think I will find a side parting does suit that environment. Definitely, yeah.
Do you... Obviously, you've got loads of rock and roll pals like the Gallaghers, you know, Coldplay and stuff.
Yeah.
Do you speak to those kind of people on a regular basis?
No, that's what I mean. It's funny, this business, because I take someone like Liam's like an island when I meet him somewhere, say, some Q Awards thing, pardon me, the other day. It's like, oh, God, thank God you're here. Because, you know, we've been through a hell of a lot, really, that's similar in ways, and I wish we saw each other more often. But because of what we've done over the last 10 years, we've always been going in different places. But when you see each other, it's like, oh, you know, it could have been yesterday. We've almost got this idea that maybe that'll happen years to come, you know, when the beer bellies are fully set in and the dartboard's out.
When you've all sat on rocking chairs.
Ah, those were the days, someone.
Well, Richard, thank you very much for chatting to us.
It's a great pleasure, mate.
Put your hands together, ladies and gentlemen, Richard Ashcroft.